Well, friends, previously we unboxed the large diorama set for the Cartoon Turtles. Now we're going to be unboxing some Movie Turtles accessories, but this diorama set is taking up my space where I usually film videos, so we're just going to go ahead and use this as the background, but first we gotta, you know, try to make it more appropriate for the movies. Alright, now we're all movie oriented, and once again, it definitely feels like April is missing. Fortunately, I did pre-order the April figure for the movies, so that it will be coming soon. Toasters. Well, soon, hopefully. It is NECA, so maybe this time next year. Alright, so today we are unboxing the accessory set for the Movie Ninja Turtle line from NECA, and unlike the cartoon diorama, this came in this nice fancy box. And we can see all the cool detail that has gone into this. So that is awesome. So even though the diorama set still looks pretty cartoony, maybe this accessory set will help it to look more movie-centric. So here it is out of the box in the plastic enclosure. And funniest thing to me, this is where the four pizza slices go, yet three of them are up here in a random place, and the other one is splattered on the panda bear. That makes me laugh. Anyway, let's go ahead and start getting these things open. Alrighty, well the first item is this cool sign that says 11th and Bleecker, which of course, if you remember the first movie, that is a street where April lives. Let's put it a little closer so you can see it. There's the 11th and Bleecker sign. And then a manhole cover, which is similar to the cartoony one, but we'll go ahead and just replace that there. All right, next item we got is the pizza box, Domino's pizza box. Actually, it says tile pizza, tile game pizza, which is not exactly Domino's, but you know, copyrights. And there actually appears to be Easter eggs all over the box, like right here. Says delivery in 30 minutes, maybe less. And then right here, drivers carry less than $20, free delivery, tile game pizza. And it says very small, we deliver everywhere on time or $3 off your order. Time's up, $3 off. You can barely see the text on here, but the date is 9/12/1990, $13, 123rd and an eighth is the address. And the name is M. Angelo. If you did not order penicillin on your pizza, please discard right away. Burr, burr, burr. So there we go. Then of course the box does open up and you can put the four pizza slices inside. Pizza slices they come with, of course. And then if you have the four turtles, they each came with a slice of pizza too. So you have a full pizza with that. Let's go ahead and we'll give this to Michelangelo. All right, and the next item we're looking at is Mikey's stuffed panda bear. Or it might be April's stuffed panda bear, but Mikey's the one who holds it. We'll just put it right there by Mikey's foot. And then we got Donatello's skateboard. Let's see, there's no pegs in the skateboard to go into Donnie's foot or anything. So it would be hilarious if we took a human hand and replace it on Donnie's hand, because in the actual movie, when we see the close-up on his feet skateboarding, we see a human hand swish by because the actor wasn't wearing gloves. Oh, speaking of Donatello, his straw hat from the farmhouse is another accessory it came with, so let's go ahead and put that on his head. All right, and then we have pork rind. So let's put it right there. Donnie drops his pork rinds. And we have corn snack chips also. Let's have those right there, I guess. I don't know. Maybe we can give these to someone. Let's give the corn snacks to Razar here. There we go. And the pork rinds can go to Toka.
Mama! Pork rinds.
Toka gets the pork rinds. Next up, we have the TCRI can. TCRI, not TGRI, huh? Interesting. We'll just go ahead and put this canister up here by Shredder. And speaking of Shredder, here's the original Shredder helmet. Very cool. Let's see. We'll put that down here by Splinter, because he collects the helmets like in TMNT. Next we have the Turtles TV set, and it has April's news report on it right there. You know, it's actually the exact same one we got before for the Turtles in Time loot crate, except that one had the changing picture from April's news report to Shredder. So, same TV, just different picture. And it doesn't have the changing effect. Let's see, TV can go right here by Splinter.
Michelangelo, where is my TV?
Next up we have the turtle wax that Michelangelo holds up at the farmhouse. Alright, there. So I had to have Mikey put the pizza down so he could hold up the turtle wax. And these next two items are actually Mikey-centric also. It is the nunchucks and a new alternate hand that he can spin the nunchucks on the tip of his finger like he did in a single scene of the movie. This is actually the exact same accessory that the larger figures came with in their accessory set. Let me show you really quick as I spin my chair. Here they are. Here are the large turtle figures, and got Michelangelo with his nunchucks spinning on his finger right there. So that is that. So yeah, I guess it worked with the big ones. So they figured they'd do it again with the smaller standard size figures. All right, so there we go. Now Mikey's got his spinning nunchucks, and he's got his turtle wax, and he's got his panda bear. A lot of Mikey accessories, and Donnie. Mikey and Donnie seem to get the most of these accessories. However, the next accessory is specifically for Raphael. It's worse, crime on the rise. This is the New York Post newspaper that Raphael reads in one scene. So let's go ahead. And actually, it's not this Raphael. All right, so there we go. There's Raphael reading his newspaper. No foot soldiers can bother him because they have no idea he's a giant turtle in a trench coat. And next up we have the baby turtles. Get four of these, four identical figures. They have arms that kind of move, heads that swivel, the legs don't really move, but yeah.
Pizza! Pizza!
There's a little close-up view of the baby turtles. We'll say this one's Michelangelo because he's eating the pizza. This one's Leonardo because he admires Splinter so much. Over here on the TV, that's Donatello because he likes to learn. And this one is Raphael because he's standing there judging Michelangelo. So here are the new heads. We got Donatello looking all happy. We got Michelangelo looking a bit more relaxed, a bit more somber. We got Raphael with a big smile looking more happy. And we got Leonardo also looking pretty happy. So these are some fun looking heads. It's interesting because I feel like previously Michelangelo has always had like the happy, goofy looking head, and the other three turtles all looked more like serious or relaxed, like they're pondering on something. And so now with these new heads, I feel like the three, you know, Leonardo, Donatello, and Raphael, you can put them with the original Michelangelo and they look like all four of them are having a party. Whereas if you just switch out Michelangelo's head, he fits in more with the other three turtles with their original heads. Like this is the head you would use when you have them all sitting around the campfire, you know, seeing the spirit of Splinter. So that is something interesting. I'm really, really scared to actually put these on the figures because they look difficult. They have the ball joint in them, which is super hard to push down onto these figures, like with Vernon, to make him into the rat form. That took me forever and it hurt my hand. So let's see, which turtle should we do? Oh boy, I think we'll do my favorite, Donatello. All right, I couldn't do it with Donatello, but I could do it with Raphael. And it was kind of difficult to get the original head off, but I think popping the new head on was actually fairly easy. So there we go. Here's Raphael with his smile on his face, and he's like, Leo, come on, you know? Righteous. Now, here's something hilarious that I noticed. So, oftentimes, NECA uses this picture, which is using the action figures to replicate the cover of the VHS movie, right? And here is the actual VHS movie. You can see they got the poses down pretty perfectly, but the faces on the figures are not right at all. Except for Michelangelo, looks pretty right. However, if we look at these new heads, Leonardo matches pretty well the cover of the VHS. Donatello matches the cover of the VHS pretty well also. Oh, it would be hilarious if they put a human mouth inside of his mouth because of that one scene where he laughs and you could see the actor inside. And then Raphael. Okay, Raphael doesn't really match, but he is smiling. So this is more in line with what's on the VHS cover. So I would not be surprised if NECA redoes this photo using the new heads, because they look a lot more like they did on the original VHS tape. All right, so that's it for the new accessories, friends. I think there were about 27 accessories. Is it worth the $50? That really depends. I mean, do you really need turtle wax or another manhole cover or, you know, another TCRI canister, which have come with the past figures? Maybe you do, you know, for whatever setups that you're doing. Maybe you do. These are cool accessories. Not necessary, but cool. Not nearly as cool as like the Toka and Razar pack, but still it's something. It's cool that they're supporting this line of figures so thoroughly. So there we go, friends. Let me know in the comments what you think. Did you get this pack? What accessories would you have liked to see that did not appear here? Or what items from any of the Turtles movies would you like to see come in future packs or as future accessories with other figures or characters? Let us know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe and have a fantastic day. Toast!